Now, the state's largest newspaper is coming under fire for its refusal to print a wedding announcement for a couple getting married this weekend in Portsmouth. The reason? It's a same-sex marriage. But despite the complaints, the union leader is sticking to its guns.
The day same-sex marriage became legal in New Hampshire, it was a proud one for Manchester native Greg Gould.
It sort of highlighted all the values we had when we grew up. Individual thinking, independence.
So despite now living in New York, Greg and his soon-to-be husband Aurelio set a wedding date for this Saturday in Portsmouth, even hiring a wedding planner to help out.
There's still a lot of nerve-wracking challenges that any couple faces when they get married.
But one challenge they didn't expect came from the state's largest newspaper, told by the union leader that since it was a same-sex marriage, the paper would not print the announcement.
I was really disappointed because the union leader is a big voice in the state of New Hampshire, and they seem to be so out of touch.
Greg even took his complaint to the publisher of the paper, but to no avail. And on Friday, the union leader released a statement saying, quote, "This newspaper has never published wedding or engagement announcements for homosexual couples. It would be hypocritical of us to do so, given our belief that marriage is and needs to remain a social and civil structure between men and women." The decision flabbergasted wedding planner Kate Parker.
We're all people, and to me as a planner, it's just a wedding. It's a wedding between two people, so let them celebrate it.
Parker even blogged about Greg and Aurelio's story on her website, and she says she was stunned by the dozens of responses.
It's pretty amazing to see a state that can, you know, can be somewhat known as a conservative state to sort of be so supportive.
In its statement, the union leader says it is not anti-gay, and since it is a privately owned paper, it's important to note that it has the right to print or not print whatever it wants. Not that Greg or Aurelio see that as an adequate response.
To specifically exclude same-sex couples in wedding announcements seems particularly vindictive.
Greg and Aurelio say they have contacted gay and lesbian groups regarding this issue, and they now say they are examining their options. And late this afternoon, the New Hampshire Freedom to Marry group released a statement that reads, in part, "While we are saddened by the union leader's policy, we are hardly surprised. We defend the constitutional rights of all, even those we disagree with, and look forward to a time when all New Hampshire families are celebrated."